It's a nice little set of screens behind us, isn't it? Look at that. What a beautiful vista. This week, the BBC is giving you the chance to shape our coverage. We're going to be in Bradford all week, taking an in-depth look at the city, but also trying to hear about the stories that you want us to cover.
Yes, this morning we're looking at business, and Breakfastina Warhurst is at our pop-up newsroom in the city's Broadway shopping centre. Good morning again.
Yes, good morning, Louise. We've come to our pop-up newsroom to talk to a panel of guests who have all started businesses because Barclays Research has showed that Bradford is the best city in Britain where you can start up a business. Lots of reasons, one being cheap business rates, another being it's a decent place to live, another being that businesses in general, a very high percentage of them, tend to succeed. We're hoping that this week in Bradford will challenge some preconceptions of the city, but these guys will not be surprised at all about the positive news coming out of Bradford. You've all set up businesses here. Ravi, we'll start with you. Initially, your printing business was in Leeds, where you studied, but you moved to Bradford. People who aren't from around here might think that Leeds is a much more natural place to start a business. So why Bradford?
Well, I can lose that perception. Obviously, yeah. I was based in Leeds. But I think in Bradford, you definitely get the lower costs. Yeah. You've also still got the transport benefits of being close to where you need to be. And overall, it's a really good place to do business.
You don't feel like you're missing out at all?
Not at all, not at all. Leeds is very close, but also Manchester and all these places.
And Hannah, you left the sunny South Sussex coast, didn't you, to come to Bradford?
Yes, 10 years ago. Yeah. Like you've already mentioned, the cost of living, the footfall around Bradford as well, anyway, just generally. Where we're located, it's on a bus street, so we're forever getting customers coming in, tourists, you know, with the historical value of Bradford anyway. I enjoy it here.
And Jack, you run a cafe that's got a shared space for the community, also for other business startups to be based there. You're quite in tune with that history that Hannah was talking about, that radical history. That's something you're quite proud of, isn't it?
Yeah, I think Bradford's a really great place in that the people...
To get you on the mic, sorry.
People are always doing things in their own communities and like helping out their own community. And the only reason that we were able to create a business that's a cooperative is because people in Bradford are so like active and like willing to get involved with things.
So you don't feel that there's those sharp elbows of competitiveness that you might get in some of the bigger cities?
Not really. I just think everyone is kind of working towards like a common goal of just like making the city better.
Yeah, it's got a really lovely feel to it, hasn't it? And Lucy, you've just started a business. Two months in, how's it gone so far? It's mastectomy tattoos, isn't it? Which is really interesting.
It's something that I've done for a couple of years, and I did it in a town in Keighley, and I felt that there was a need for it. People were travelling to me from all over the country, so I felt it was a natural next big step for me to move forward into a city. And Bradford is up and coming. The government's investing so much into it. It's growing every year in different senses, and it just seemed like the best option.
You feel proud of it?
Absolutely, yeah. Definitely.
Just a quick question to all of you. Do you feel like perceptions of Bradford are inaccurate and you find that frustrating?
At times, yes.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's being portrayed that it's just a racing town and known for drugs and violence, when in actual fact we're not. We have a lot of independent businesses, and we have a lot of things that are unique that aren't in other cities. So
a good place to bring up kids.
Definitely.
You've done it four times, Hannah.
Yes, I know.
She managed to get all the school uniforms ready before leaving this morning, which is very impressive. Richard is from Yorkshire Water. Good morning. Good to see
good morning.
You. That's a massive company, isn't it? You look after 5 million people's water. You're operating profits of almost £300 million.
Yep.
Long established in Bradford, and you've never moved out for nearly 100 years.
No, that's right. I mean, we're a permanent institution in Bradford, an anchor, if you like, of the local economy, and we're very proud of that fact. But actually, Bradford's got a really radical history as far as the way in which it manages its water and its wastewater. So back in the 1920s, the city invested heavily in reservoirs up in Nidderdale to make sure it had water supply for the then dominant wool industry. It also invested hugely in big wastewater treatment works to take the lanolin out of the effluent, and actually, would you believe it, to make lipstick and soap.
Oh, right, okay.
You fast forward about 60 years, privatisation meant that we were able to invest and modernise the network here, attach Bradford's water to the grid in Yorkshire, so it would give much more security of supply, and also modernise wastewater treatment such that, I mean, the air that flows through Bradford used to be biologically dead. As a result of our investment, you can virtually use it for drinking water.
So that sort of radical history of technology, do you think that's something that's carrying on now?
I think it is. One of the two things that surprise people about Bradford is, one is it's one of the biggest centres for advanced manufacturing outside of London, and second is the amount of self-employment that's here. Something like 30,000 people in Bradford are self-employed.
Why is that, do you think?
I think there's a real entrepreneurial spirit here, and I think the diversity of the population also helps. So people come from lots of different backgrounds, and that's built some great skills in the city.
We said it to Ravi earlier, a big established company like yours, you've never been tempted to move to Leeds or one of the bigger cities. It's always Bradford for you.
Well, we obviously we supply all of Yorkshire, but Bradford remains our big operational centre, but we do employ people throughout the county.
Okay, not tempted to move anywhere else?
No.
And do you find it frustrating then when people have this perception of Bradford that you might find inaccurate?
I think it is frustrating. As I said earlier, the stats I think would surprise a lot of people, how much advanced manufacturing there is here, how entrepreneurial the spirit is of the place, and physically the environment's improved a lot in the last 20 years as a result of things that the council have done, inward investment coming in, and the sort of spirit of the people you've got.
Which you've seen from our panel this morning.
Yes.
What does Bradford have to look forward to then in the next decade?
Well, let me just talk about one small example. Our big sewage works up at Esholt, not a very glamorous site, you wouldn't have thought.
Yeah.
But we're just putting in planning permission to turn that into a sustainable housing development, a centre for digital and data industries where we can use the heat and water that's generated on the site to become a sort of beacon of the circular economy. You've already got a strong digital sector here in Bradford, so I think those two things combined are a very exciting and forward-thinking future for the city.
So that radical history and that forward-looking attitude to technology is maintaining. I just want to take you around here for a second to have a look at our pop-up newsroom. You can see behind here the blue room. Just behind those screens we have the Today programme here, who are broadcasting live.
That's great.
And behind there we have we also have our vision mixers who are making sure all of this gets broadcast over the internet to you. But the most important thing is that we hear from you. If you think we're doing our jobs in the wrong way, we're not telling the stories that matter to you, that are positive about your communities, come in here or use the hashtag BBCWeAreBradford to tell your story and to help us to get it right.
7:49. Now, this week, we're giving you the chance to shape our coverage. We've been in Bradford.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be there all week, looking sort of in-depth look at the city, but also trying to find out the stories that you want us to cover.
This morning, we are particularly looking at business and breakfast. Nina Warhurst is at our rather lovely pop-up newsroom in the city's Broadway shopping centre. Morning.
Yes, good morning, Louise. Welcome to our pop-up newsroom. I'll give you a little bit of a guided tour a bit later on, but this morning we are talking about business in Bradford because, according to Barclays' new research, it is the best place in Britain to start up a business because rates are low, it's a good place to live, and also the most companies here succeed rather than going under. So let's talk to some people who know all about it. We'll start with you, Hannah. You've worked for a chocolate company here for 2 years. It's the first in the city. What is it about Bradford, do you think, that's seen it take off in such a successful way?
The fact that we're the only chocolate shop in the city.
That helps.
We're in an iconic historic building, so the fact that tourism is drawn to that, so we have the footfall of people wanting to visit the city. The regeneration of Bradford in itself anyway, so we're wanting more businesses to come to Bradford to regenerate and have their own stamp and be kind of unique to the rest of the other shops that are already here.
And in terms of that regeneration, Ravi, you set up a printing plastics company in Bradford. Have you found that the council have been supportive, that the infrastructure around here has been helpful?
Absolutely. One unique thing about Bradford is the small business rates relief. So I believe up to £12,000 can be 100% discounted, which you wouldn't find anywhere else. So for a relatively new business, it's definitely a big help to the cash flow.
Yeah, that's massively important when you're getting yourself off the ground, isn't it?
Absolutely.
And for you, Jack, when you've set up a cooperative, a cafe where people can come and share the workspace, how integral has it been to do it in Bradford? How much of a difference has the people made here?
It really comes down to the people in Bradford.
Yeah.
Because when you have a co-op, which is a business which is like owned and run by its members, we're really fortunate in Bradford to have like a really vast range of really creative people, and I feel like everyone in the city is like working really hard towards the same common vision, so we're really lucky to be working.
And do
with
you
people.
All find that people in Bradford are really proud of Bradford and want to sort of support other businesses here?
Yeah, definitely.
Lucy, you've set up a mastectomy tattoo clinic.
Yeah.
Very, very recently.
Yeah, very.
And have you found people want to support it because it's in Bradford?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. We've had amazing feedback from the local newspapers and just generally
in general, people supporting us and the cause for what we do. So, yeah, it's been really special.
Do you all sort of feel that Bradford is regenerating well, that it is the start of something a lot bigger?
For sure, definitely, yeah. Definitely.
And I have to say, last night, guys, I went out to a pub that was showing the football and serving amazing Indian food, which to me is the perfect Sunday, so I will be back. Thank you very much. We're going to talk now to David Potts. He's the chief executive of Morrisons. You will probably have a Morrisons store near you. There are 500 of them around the country, employing 101,000 people, and they have been here in Bradford since 1899. Nearly knocked you over there, David. Very good morning to you.
Good morning.
How much is Bradford a part of Morrisons? How much is Morrisons a part of Bradford?
Well, it's our home.
Yeah.
And so on that basis, it's a very big part of the company. And, you know, our founder was born here, and he built the business from pretty much nothing to what it is today. And I think on our side, we're here to play our part in the future success of this city, and we're ready to do that.
It's not unusual for something to go from one shop, one business in a place like Bradford, but unfortunately be seduced by the biggest cities, Leeds, Manchester, London. Why is that not happening? Would you ever be tempted to leave?
We'd never be tempted to leave. I think we're blessed with fabulous people here. We're a big employer in the city. 5,000 out of that 101,000 you quoted are here.
Right.
We are a food maker as well as a shopkeeper in Britain, and therefore, you know, that breadth of skills is really quite important to this business. We have two manufacturing sites here in Bradford, 5 stores, and our head office is here with 1,600 people.
What would you say to companies who might be considering moving out of other cities and looking for somewhere else? What are the advantages of being away from those bigger cities?
Well, to move at all is a big change.
Yeah.
Always a bit more traumatic than I think people expect. Mm. But yeah, give it a go. We're here and very welcoming. It's a very diverse city in the case of Bradford. And yeah, we are a little bit squeezed in the end between Leeds and probably Manchester, but it is a diverse city. It's the youngest city, I think, in Britain.
Yes.
And it's moving forward.
It's been lovely to hear how businesses support one another here as well. Just a couple of questions from the news agenda this week. One on knife crime. We know that Asda have said they're going to take single blades off the shelves in the near future. Is that something you'd look at?
Well, the current situation, I think, is a blight on the country. Mm. Last April, we withdrew single blade knives in London, 18 stores. We're happy to talk to the authorities about taking that further.
Okay.
And the industry, to be honest, the industry is often quite responsible in these cases.
Okay, so that might be something you consider rolling out a bit wider. And very quickly, Brexit, massive week ahead, presumably like a lot of businesses, you're looking for certainty. How important is it to get an answer as soon as possible on the deal?
I think it's more important to get the right answer.
Okay.
You know, there can be dates in diaries, but you need the right answer. In the end, our job is to run Morrisons, not the country.
So you would rather there was a delay on Thursday if it comes to a Thursday vote on the 29th?
I'd rather people do their very best work and see where it takes us. It's very close at hand, so I wouldn't like to predict the future.
Impact so far on business?
Well, we've done our best to prepare for a degree of uncertainty. So we're as prepared as you can be.
Okay, without actually knowing. Just to quickly show us, thank you, David, and the rest of our newsroom, which will be here for the rest of the week. This is the augmented reality area with the team, who can show you the best of BBC digital technology if you want to come down and have a look. The idea is that this newsroom will be here for the whole week, telling stories of Bradford, the good, the bad and the ugly, but we want it to come from you. Use the hashtag BBC We Are Bradford, and if possible, come down here and see us.